إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ما يهدي الله فلا مضل له وما يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, all praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek His help and His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from our soul's evils and our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can guide. I bear witness and testify that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And I bear witness and testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final messenger of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal, He praises our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the Quran by describing him, wa innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim, and surely you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is of noble rank when it comes to your manners. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reminded in the Quran, had he not had good manners, walau kunta faddan ghalid al-qalb lam faddu min hawlik, if you were harsh in your character, if you were harsh towards the people, then the people would have turned away from you. And therefore our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is made a noble model for us when it comes to good manners. He, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, despite his state and rank, is reminded that if you did not have good manners, the people would have turned away from you. Your da'wah would have been ineffective. That is why our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, bu'ithtu li'utammima husnul akhlaq, the only reason why I came is to perfect good manners. So this topic of akhlaq and manners is something that we always talk about in our khutubs and our lectures, but unfortunately we find in the ummah lacking in manners. We find that the Muslims don't know how to deal with non-Muslims, youngsters don't know how to deal with the elders, and so on and so forth. So we need to keep reminding each one of us about the importance of good manners. So in this brief khutbah, I will mention some of the blessings of good manners, so we can be motivated to have good manners inshallah. My dear brothers in Islam, when a sahabi came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for advice, it was always relating back to manners. When a sahabi came and he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, give me some advice, and our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, لا تغضب, don't get angry. And the man felt shortchanged, and he wanted more than that. And he asked him again, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept on repeating, لا تغضب, لا تغضب, لا تغضب, do not get angry. And this all goes back to manners. Once Mu'adh ibn Jabal came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and gave him advice, and he said, O Mu'adh, اتقي الله حيث ما كنت. O Mu'adh, have the taqwa of Allah wherever you are, and when you do a bad deed, follow it up with a good deed. وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ, and wherever you are with the people, be good to them, treat them well, have good manners towards the people. Another companion came to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he wanted some advice, and our beloved Prophet said, اِشْتَنِبُ الْكَبَائِرِ, avoid the major sins and overlook the faults of others. In other words, be gentle, be forgiving, be gentle. And this all goes back to manners. Of the blessings of akhlaq, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that people cannot be given a better blessing than husnul khuluq. No one is more blessed than a person that has good manners. Your money, your wealth, everything is secondary, because how many people in this world that have the blessings of this world, but yet they are despised by mankind, they are hated by mankind. But wallahi, you could be a person that has nothing of this world, but because of your manners, people love you, the community will love you. Why? Because of your good manners. So your manners is the best treasure that you have, that people will appreciate you for. Also, another advice that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave to a companion, عَلَيْكَ بِحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ, I encourage you, I advise you to have good manners and observe long periods of silence For the one whose hands is my soul, the creation is not beautified by anything other than these two things. مَا تَجَمَّلَ الْخَلَاقُ بِمِثْلِهَا. The creation is not beautified by anything other than these two things. Good manners and keeping silent for a long period of time. Why? Because the more we talk, the more trouble we get into. And the less we talk, the less trouble we get into. Of the blessings of manners, that most of us, we are shortchanged when it comes to our religion, when it comes to the worship of Allah. We're not reciting Quran as much as we should. We're not doing dhikr as much as we should. We're not fasting and praying and worshipping Allah as much as we should. And we feel an immense sense of guilt. And we should feel an immense sense of guilt. But there is a way. There is a way that we can reach that level. The level of sawam qawam. There is a way that we could reach the level of the one who is always fasting. The one who's always praying the night prayers. By your good manners, بحسن خلقه. So realize, if you cannot reach that level, if you cannot reach the level of an elite Muslim, as long as you're a good Muslim, you avoid the major sins, you're decent, you're okay, but you cannot reach that level, then you can reach that level through your good manners, inshallah. So of the blessings of manners, is our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, having good manners is a sign of iman. Therefore, if you don't have good manners, you don't really have iman. And one simple hadith that many of us have heard many times, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, akmalu al-mu'minina imanan ahsanuhum khuliqa. The most perfect believers in the iman are those with the best manners. Therefore, having good manners and having good iman, they go hand in hand. Two words, my dear brothers, which summarizes the gist of akhlaq. Ad-deenu ma'amala. The religion is judged by the way you interact with others. The religion is judged by the way you interact with others. So the people of iman are those with the best manners. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Al-mu'min layyinun hayyin. The believer, he's gentle, he's easygoing, he's modest, he's humble, he's not arrogant, he's not vainglorious. Our sharia tells us, good akhlaq and good iman go hand in hand. Of the blessings of akhlaq, my dear brothers, the people of good manners are those whom Allah Azza wa Jal loves, and those with bad manners are those whom Allah Azza wa Jal does not love. And we all know the beautiful hadith that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Inna Allah jameelun yuhibbul jamal, that Allah is beautiful and he loves beauty. Wa yuhibbu ma'ali al-akhlaq, and he loves the good manners. Wa yakrahu safsafaha, and he hates the low debased manners. Allah is beautiful and he loves beauty, and part of beauty is having good manners. Because what makes you beautiful in the eyes of the people? When you have beautiful manners, my dear brothers, when you have good manners, it makes you beautiful in the eyes of the people. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, shouldn't I tell you who Jannah has been made haram? They said, who, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? He said, the one with a vulgar tongue, bad manners and arrogance in his heart, Jannah has been made haram for that individual. Of the blessings of good manners are the weightiest thing in the scales after our iman in Allah on the day of judgment. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, hadith found in At-Tirmidhi, مَا شَيْءٌ أَكْثَلُ فِي مِيزَانِ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ خُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. The heaviest thing in the scales on the day of judgment will be your good manners after having La ilaha illallah, of course. Someone asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what is the one factor that will help me go to Jannah the most? What is the one factor? He said, تَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. Taqwa of Allah, this is iman and good manners, my dear brothers. This shows us, my dear brothers, that having good iman and good manners go hand in hand, inshallah. And this is one of the easiest ways to get to Jannah, of the blessings of good manners. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, the closest to me on the day of judgment are those with the best akhlaq, and the furthest of those who are away from me on the day of judgment and in Jannah are those with the worst manners. So your akhlaq will dictate your interaction with our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the next life. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, my dear brothers in Islam, akhlaq is of the quintessential realities of our religion. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent to perfect good manners, inshallah. And we can all be good in the eyes of the people, but if you demonstrate bad manners at home, in front of your children and your wife and at home, then if your wife and your and children, your family members can testify that you are a person of good manners, then inshallah you are a person of good manners, because we can all put an act on when we're out with our friends. But who can truly testify? If your spouse, your wife can testify that you are a person of good manners, then inshallah you are a person of good manners. Ibadallah, inna Allah bada bi nafsi thumma thanna bi malaikat kutsi faqalu wa lam yazal qaila inna Allah wa malaikatu yusallun ala nabiyya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya' minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qarib mujibud du'a. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إننا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.